grandfather's clock was too tall for the shelf, so it stood 90 years on the floor. It was taller by half than the old man himself, though it weighed not a penny weight more. It was bought on the morn of the day that he was born. It was always his treasure and pride, but it stopped short, never to go again when the old man died. And watching its pendulum swing to and fro, many hours he had spent as a boy. In childhood and manhood, the clock seemed to know and share in his sorrow and joy. It struck 24 when he entered at the door with his blooming, beautiful bride. But it stopped short, never to go again when the old man died. 90 years without lumbering, his life second numbering. But it stopped short, never to go again when the old man died. My grandfather said that of those he could hire, not a servant so faithful he found. For it wasted no time and had but one desire, at the end of each week to be wound. Yet it kept in its place, not a frown upon its face, and its hands never hung by its side. But it stopped short, never to go again when the old man died. It sounded an alarm in the dead of the night, an alarm that for years had been dumb. Then we knew that his spirit was plumbing for flight, and his hour of departure had come. Yet the clock kept the time with a soft and muffled chime as we waited there by his side. But it stopped short, never to go again when the old man died. 90 years without slumbering, his life seconds numbering. But it stopped short, never to go again when the old man died.